So today we'll be learning about the theta notation. So it is like denoted something like this. The symbol is like this. So we already know that big O is the upper bound for a function and big omega is the lower bound for it. And if the two bounds agree, then the function is sandwiched. And this is the big theta of the common function. So let me explain what it means. Suppose we have a function like f of n. And we take two functions, c1 g of n and c2 g of n, something like this. So f of n must lie between these two, so that is the sandwich part. So I'll explain with the help of a graph. Suppose we have a graph something like this. This is the n, and suppose we have like something, a function called c2 g of n. And suppose this is a function like c1 g of n, and our sandwich function is something like this. This is our f of n. So this explains the theta notation. So we need to define something like this. So our like condition is something like 0 less than c1 g of n must be less than f of n, and this f of n must be less than c2 g of n. So this right here is the main condition, and let me write something like this. So theta g of n is what? F of n function, there exists constants, like positive constants, the constants are c1 c2 and n0, such that this condition is valid for all values of n0. So I'm writing it once again. So this is valid for all n greater than n0. I'll explain this with the help of an example. So already I have taken this 3n plus 2. Now we need to prove it to theta of n. We have done for, so we'll consider f of n to be 3n plus 2. We'll consider c2 g of n 4n and c1 g of n that to be 3n. So this right here will give us the omega of n in my previous video. That was, and this will give what, the big O of n. So that was in my first video. So I've already solved the values, so I'll just write it. So for theta it was something like this. So 3n plus 2, that was less than equals to 4n for all values of n greater than equals to 2. Okay, this was for order of n, that is c2 g of n. Now, and for c1 g of n, it was something like this, 3n plus 2, that was greater than 3n, so this was for all n greater than equals to 1. And so we have like already found out this. So finally we can write this, 0 is less than equals to what, 3n, and this is less than equals to what, 3n plus 2, and this is less than equals to 4n for all values of n that must be greater than equals to 1, because we'll take the intersection of these two n's, and for this was 1 2 3, and this starts from, so we'll start from 2, sorry, this will be 2. So this is our final answer. So thanks for watching.